Monday. San Clemente. It's beautiful. All clouded in.
Mm-hmm.
Better than the... It was already 80 something at my house when I left.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Dude, it was misting.
It's supposed to be like 100 degrees in Corona today. So we're getting some riding in before the office and the podcast and some other baloney. Riding my Stumpy. Chase and I are both Stumpy Evo teammates today. Yeah. And it's going to be hard getting used to the dry shit of SoCal coming from Hawaii. But you and the bushes off. Quick ride, only two runs. It was all cloudy when we started, but now it's hot as... You know, we had this really wet, cold winter, and even a cold, foggy June. I think July through October is going to kick our asses.
Here at Intense. Come on! She's locking me out because she doesn't want to vlog. Are you that camera shy?
Welcome to Intense.
Are you wearing an Intense shirt today?
I am.
Yeah.
Right here, look at this.
Avoiding the write-up. There you go. Oh, you really did wear your spandex.
Oh my God, Don.
Okay, what are we doing here today?
You're picking up your Taser alloy.
Mm.
Look at this. Ready up SWAT moto bottle and everything.
Yeah, look at that. So, how was the response to the new bike then?
The response has been incredible. So yeah. The new geometry of the body, people have really liked it. They like the silver. They love that it's alloy and aluminum, especially in the power sports industry. Yeah, it's got a bigger battery.
Bigger battery.
Bigger motor.
And streamlined frame appearance, right? Don't you think?
Stop.
Look at that.
Yeah, it looks great.
Good. And I'm very impressed with the TRP brakes.
Great TRP brakes.
Yeah, what happened with the shifter?
The shifter essentially, just because it needed an adjustment right here, so we adjusted it so that you will no longer have that hit.
Oh, okay, so it's the same shifter.
Yes, same
shifter. It just needs to be adjusted.
Yep, just need to be adjusted.
And will that be a quality control checklist from now on?
Not like, necessarily. It's very rare that that happens.
I thought it happened on a couple other bikes.
It happened on a Pro, but that was because of the ratting. So it just needed to be adjusted.
Okay. Now, also, come on, tell me, give me the sales pitch. What's the rest? $74.99.
$74.99 for the Pro build. Here it is.
And there's a $1,000 discount.
And there's a $1,000.
How long is that code good for?
It is good until further notice.
Okay.
Subject to change at any time.
The code is like 1HRP or something?
IFR1K.
IFR1K.
Correct.
Intense Factory Racing 1000.
Yep.
There we go. Okay. So contrary to popular belief, this bike has not touched the ground yet.
It has not touched the ground.
You thought I ate shit and bent the shifter.
Okay, I never said that you crashed.
You told Slater that.
Rumor mill. That's how rumors happen through the telephone game.
Yeah, so anyway, I dropped it off because of the shifter issue, and it's been resolved, and this bike rules.
Woo!
So it's set. So we're doing the 24 KTM 250 and 450 today. Got Kyle Vara out, Captain America. He's got the red bud kit on.
Yep.
With the matching, what was the helmet called?
Renegade.
Renegade helmet. I think it's sick.
Just came out.
Limited edition. You need this Moto 10 if you're a red blooded American. Go check your snag.
How's it look?
It looks good.
Perfect.
How's it look compared to my 1996 throwback?
That's the retro stuff.
Barbed wire. It's got the barbed wire retro fit too. Renee's in 24 O'Neill Mayhem. Looks good, good, good.
Oh.
inventory. Oh man, you scratched up the pipe.
No, I probably.
Hey, what?
Oh yeah,
today, I gave you them braces and you don't work.
I didn't want to have to take time today to put them on.
You sold them, huh? You sold them on Facebook Marketplace.
I got them for $50. I don't need $50. Hey, come get your cousin, man.
Hey, why aren't you wearing them? Serious.
Because I didn't feel like putting them on today. And then I want to, I wear them with certain gear.
Are you serious?
Yup.
Is it kind of like sometimes you take a doo-doo? I didn't feel like wiping today.
Oh my God. Huh? Hey, man, get your cousin, man. He's Indian too.
Huh?
I'm serious.
Man. I'm flabbergasted you're not wearing those.
He wants me to wear knee braces every time I
Oh, yeah, he begged me for some knee braces. I gave him them, and he's wearing those things.
I go back and forth.
Shit. Okay, where's your new truck? Gonna put your socks up there?
Yeah, they're already back there.
No, they fell down. What do you think of the purple accents on the bike?
I think you're matching, dude.
Oh, I'm matching, yeah.
I'm telling you, it's a retro throwback. It's that.
No, but I don't know about the pink. I don't know about the purple on the bike.
It's the 90s or 80s.
This is like the year of Mike Fisher rode a KTM that was white and purple. I think white, purple, and orange. Yeah, it was orange.
Before
I don't
my
know.
Time, I gotta do my history.
KTM should be all orange, everything.
Yeah.
Orange number plates, orange fork guard. None of this purple. I don't know.
Renee.
Yeah.
Do you remember this gear? When Jeff Matasevich wore it?
I think I was born like 10 years.
10 years after?
Yeah.
Did you see my post? I wore it on the cover of Cycle News.
Oh, really?
On a Suzuki 250.
Nice.
And it looks exactly the same.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Scrub Daddy riding the Works Edition 450.
I can't afford chicken.
And let's check this out. Since Scrubby don't pay for anything motocross, he can afford to buy a new truck every year.
Yeah, right. Every year I have my last truck for 5 years.
Look at this thing.
I had one more year to pay it off. I don't know why I didn't.
Your wife had one more year?
I did. Fit?
Hey, you did.
I'm not a pimp.
Hey.
What
are you kind of? Hey, he don't have no job.
Yeah,
he just supplies the meat at home. You know, little meat, but.
Why?
No, let's check out his new rig. Whoa, it came with 20s?
The meat man.
Huh? Hey, come do the Dub magazine pose. It came with these big wheels?
Yeah, man, I upgraded.
Come on, go down there like a magazine cover. There you go. Dub Automotive Lifestyles. Let's see what he's got in here. There's nothing in here yet. What is this? What is that? A kidney stone? Oh, look, he keeps this on there. You know, because at home he still has the plastic on his couches. Man, it smells good in there. It smells, you know what it smells like in there? Gravy. Oh, look at this. Oh, what? Why has he got that? Hey, why do you got this towel in the back seat?
I take it out my last truck.
You got a towel in the back seat so you don't leave no stains? Look at this.
I can't wait to see the
same team. This pulls up. His hat. Oh, man. Look at all the grease on that. Woo! Wait. What is this?
He's gonna go through the whole thing.
What is this? Is this from the top of your champagne bottles? I'll put it back on. That's his. Hey, is this your rib for her pleasure?
Nah, it came with that.
Uh-huh. Come on. Damn. Look at this. Look at this.
Man, come back with Renee. Look at him.
Gravy. Hey, we're gonna make you a gravy butt patch.
Oh, that'd be sick.
Huh? Gravy.
You got everybody saying that gravy. Now.
You raced the whole Supercross mm-hmm. series with Honda HRC, and then you're doing the World Supercross with Rick Ware Racing. So,
yeah, it kind of started a little step by step. Really, the first thing was this would be cool to do if I could do it, based on the point situation. So, first step was contacting Rick and being like, "Hey, are you okay with this?" Because, I mean, I'm contracted to race World Supercross only. Luckily, they've just been really cool about it. They were like, "Hey, like, we want to try and help you, but it's going to be a stretch. Like, obviously, we pay you to race World Supercross, and that's it." So, luckily, though, they were cool. And after that, I was like, "Okay, how can I kind of piece this together and make this work?" And I've just been lucky. I've had a lot of people step up and help, like, obviously, yourself riding your bike. And that was a really big help. Otherwise, we were going to go buy one at a dealership and just kind of figure it out as we went. And Washougal really snuck up on us, but it's kind of somewhat the closest one of these last four, so it just seemed like logistically this was the best one we could do. Are we a little rushed and as prepared as I'd want to be? No, you know, like, of course, but we're gonna make the best of it. I like I said, a lot of people stepped up the past 2 days. I've got to do some really good testing with Dave Cruz, and just, like, I don't know, like, unexpected, you know, things are happening and people are stepping up to help the cause. But otherwise, yeah, I mean, we're paying Nichols Racing out of pocket to travel there and, you know, to get my mechanic there. And, you know, I rented A-Ray's van for the weekend. That was a big help. So yeah, just some little stuff, but we're be back in Privateer Island. It'll just be a fun deal, though, you know, like a cool thing for me to try to tackle. I've never raced an outdoor on a 450, so this is going to completely new for me and a first experience. So I'm just excited. I've always wanted to race. I feel like we got the bike, you know, pretty dialed in now with a few days on it. And I'm just excited. It's going to be a fun adventure.
We say big dog. It's hot, huh? It's hot. Anton's in Vancouver, Washington.
Yes, yeah.
We're in Vancouver, Canada, and on our way to Whistler Pike Park to spend a few days with Jeremy McGrath and the Maxxis Tires crew, and Rob Salcedo of Leah, and it's going to be fun. It's been a year since I've been here. 2 years for you, right? Or three?
Three, I think, yeah.
Three.
3 years.
The last time I was here is not so good. It was our buddy Emter. Broke both of his heels. We're on the shuttle now. 2.5 hour drive. Nice and green. They've almost lied and said we were in Washougal. Watched on Peacock on the phone. Next 4 days should be interesting. First things first, gotta build the bike. That's how she looks in the bag. Already took the wheels out. And Chase said I should time lapse it. Probably take about 20 minutes, I think. All right, our first trip up the hill. The line took 34 minutes. Not too bad. I've had Summit take that long before on the weekend. This is nerve-wracking. I guess you back-ended.
Drop that thing.
All right, we're at the top. We're about to take our first run down the hill.
So I guess Una Moss is goes down to all the other trails. So work our way through the hikers. Haven't ridden this bike in a year. Last person to ride it was Coupon. Whoa. You all right? I had to get out of the way. Dude, that rock was slippery. I was trying to change lines, you know? No joke. That's a course, so.
Is that Don Maeda?
Yeah.
Hey, Adam Green.
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah.
You know your way around here?
What's that?
You know your way around here?
A little bit. What are you looking for?
How do we get to A-Line and Dirt Merchant?
You can basically just go down like freight train. Just stay like this way, basically.
Okay.
Freight train and we're heading that way, kind of.
Okay.
You guys are faster than us, but.
Oh, I remember that jump. Ooh, that didn't feel good. Dude, it's so rusty. it's so rough. Here. Not the smartest move. Pushed out. at the Maxxis booth. It's good to see a poster of the King here inside a bicycle festival. H-I, I-H-S-I. There he is. Hey, look at that.
Yeah.
You know that guy?
Some squid.
Oh shit. You okay?
Okay, end of riding day one. No fatalities, no crash. Well, I crashed. We're at our fancy restaurant. Got DL Wood with us. This place is kind of too fancy for my Crocs.
A little fancy. No?
Oh, they're Adidas clogs.
Guess he's not getting laid tonight.
I'm here with McGrath.
Pretty far.
His nephew, Chase. Oh, Jeremy's ordering drinks.
Super fun downhill.
Beverages.
So we have about 15,000 plus bottles in here. We have 2,000 different labels. We have some of the most rarest wines in Canada, and the total value appraised would be roughly about $3 million. Everything is organized.
Don't touch!
Yeah.
Don't touch!
Please make photos, make videos. Just want to let you know, everything's organized by region. For example, we have Burgundy right here. As you know, Burgundy is some of the most expensive wines. So those ones here are from Domaine Romani Conti, which is a very small, small producer in Burgundy. He has a monopole, so in that area where he is, he's the only one producing it, but makes him so rare and exclusive.
How much for that bottle right there?
So the Romani Sauvignon is $6,500, and when you go up to the top ones, where you see the Lantage, they are roughly about $20,000 to $25,000.
Oh, for
they take offers.
For a bottle.
They take offers. It's like buying a car.
You ever feel like a trailer park dude in the room?
No, well, I'll just go for the staff.
Okay. And then here. Yeah, so on this side we got our.
I don't think they have any in cardboard boxes here.
You know how long a $25,000 bottle of wine would last me?
A long time.
Show them the old dusty dog in the back there.
Oh yeah, so then here we got our nice Petrus right there. Come over here.
Oh, this is my wheelhouse.
Here you go. So that's our 73 Petrus.
73 Petrus.
Yeah, 73 Petrus. That is 8.5.
Eight and a half thousand.
Then here we have, that is something really unique. I want to show you this one here. That is Chateau Aubryon 2010. This is honestly for me one of the best wine bottles we have here.
2010?
It's 100 point Parker.
Really?
Yeah. So really thing. So recently in London on an auction, they sold a six pack for this for $45,000.
A six pack?
Six pack,
yeah. We need a saber for the vlog. Come on.
Come on, it's like a ceremonious thing. Saber something.
Yeah.
Come on.
Jeremy's got it.
Good. Jeremy. All right. If you want to make a video, the best point would be right here to stand right there. Okay. And you're going to shoot right
from in.
Yeah.
Then let me get out of the way.
Okay. Are you left or right-handed?
I'm right.
Okay.
I'm perfect. Left, but I... Do,
yeah, you can.
He savers right.
You save right.
Nice. I love it. Okay. What I want you to do is you hold the bottle like this. Okay. You go up and down, and whenever you fulfill, you gotta cut it right here. Okay.
Get the lip.
Get the lip. Exactly.
Get the lip.
Watch your thumb.
Yep.
Do you like
it? I need my thumb, so I don't want to get that.
Yeah, I think you need it. Perfect. Get a little feeling for it, okay?
Yep.
And what you want to do is you want to hit it right here, okay?
You don't want to lose the bottle as you're going.
No, so you don't.
Just
bank right.
There you go, okay?
So,
here you go.
Okay. Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
Okay.
Not like this, yeah.
Right
there. Yeah, right there, okay. Perfect.
All right, you ready?
Yay! Yeah! Look at that. I like a pro shot, right?
It's the teacher.
Oh, nice.
Over there.
Okay. So this one here is for you. That's your good luck charm. You keep that for 2023. In order to keep the good luck, Napoleon said you have to save it at least once a year.
Okay. I do, but not with a bottle.
Yeah, Phil.
You don't want to be fucking...
No, I don't want to freeze to death.
You don't want to be,
I don't have enough meat in my bones, so...
Yeah, me too.
You know, I'm intermittent fasting, so...
Everyone's doing it.
I gotta
do it now. Thank you. I want everyone to do it without.
You're the tough guy in the group, then.
Definitely.
You're the only
one. I suggest you do it.
No, I've done it before. I'm good. Everyone's else.
What do you mean you're good?
Thank you.
Do you have any vapes or something on you? Because it freezes and breaks.
No way.
Vapes, like
vapes?
E-cigarettes.
No.
Do we look like douchebags?
If you drink like 10 shots in there and you wouldn't really feel it,
she's not
when
okay.
You go outside, it might be a bit... It might kick in a bit.
The
drink's going to be smooth, clean. You drink it, it's gone for the plain vodka. If we have fruity or sweet ones, the fruity ones are like fruit juice with 35% alcohol.
So you can those shirts off.
No cuddling you. You can't be asking to like, warm you up later.
You do it.
I'm doing it.
Hey, so now my...
We're really doing it, Gabe.
So who's going to take their jacket off now?
Yeah.
Not me.
Yeah, why?
Why
be comfortable, eh?
Don't you live in fucking Kelowna, you bitch?
Yeah. I live in the desert of BC.
And it's harder in the winter.
Yeah, you can... That's a mirror for us. Not for the people outside. Same here. So I have lots of girls in here flashing their titties. Yeah. And everyone that's sees it. They're giving a show for everyone. I have a horrible job for the worst.
I want to see the girls flashing their titties. Someone actually...
Yeah. Like, the only one we got is a game with no jacket.
I just want to know. Is someone's dumb as fuck to lick this thing?
Last week I had a bunch of sucking each other's tongues around. It's not like a metal pole. How many are we? 136. 9. Great. So yeah, there's a bunch of 45-year-old women sucking each other's tongues in here. That's also a thing from time to time. Very nice. Yeah, we have like 60 different vodkas in here. Where do you guys think most of it comes from?
Russia?
Poland is a super, it's a great guess though. We don't have a single Russian vodka in here. They just drink a lot. They don't have that many famous brands. Most of it is Polish, Dutch, French, and Swedish.
Huh.
Yeah. So we're going to start off with a plain vodka. Second round, something sweet. And fourth round, whatever. And if you like the taste of vodka, I have some disgusting shit for you. I hear Americans drink a lot of Tito's, potato vodka. That's potato vodka as well.
That's dog shit.
From Pemberton, 20 minutes north here. In each bottle, they have 15 pounds of potatoes. And when they distill it, they don't even wash the potatoes. So it's a nice, earthy, muddy potato.
Oh, yeah.
Really strong.
It's some disgusting shit.
Sounds like we don't want that one.
Oh, I didn't sell this one. So we're going to start off with kettle one. It's 100% grain. Will be really smooth compared to outside. And depending on your rigs, we can go for the disgusting shit, the strong one, or the girl stuff. That's for the girl stuff.
We're like, kettle one it is.
We're
going to
both
get
shots.
Before I'm lost.
How are you doing?
Someone will join me
soon. One more shot?
Here?
Yeah.
Cheers!
Give us a good toast!
Cheers! 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 Here's to you! Here's to me! Cheers. 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 Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.